there are two ways to set up for a hold on the G1000. One, using the OBS. The other one, which it's mainly found in the newer systems of the G1000, is the built-in hold option. At the current moment, this is our holding clearance. Hold east of Gleno on vector 134. Standard turns, expect further clearance time is 2150 Sulu. Time now is 2113. The first method we're gonna do is on the newer models to have the built-in option on the menu. What we're going to do is we are going to push the FMS knobs, highlight Gleno, hold that waypoint. We have the option of doing math, or we can select the inbound or the outbound. In this case, we are going to do the inbound of 247. The time is 1:30 because we are at 17,000 feet. Standard turns, expected further clearance time is 2150. Next thing I'm going to do is press enter, and I will press enter. So now we have built a hold. We can actually see it here in our map that it does match. So here it goes, 0.1 miles. So we actually started the turn at 0.3 miles prior to the fix. And now it automatically enters the hold. The CDI goes into a suspend mode, and we'll see that here on the PFD, we'll see the suspend mode is highlighted. And the airplane will actually stay in the hold until we exit the hold. In Denver Center, Cessna 106 Tango established on the hold at Gleno, 17,000 feet. Now, some Garmin G1000s do not have this function. For the second method, we have to be between Lindsay and Gleno. I'm gonna come over the PFD and I'm gonna highlight the OBS function. And now we have enter the OBS mode, which we can actually change the course off where we wanna fly. This would also place and is not gonna let Gleno sequence to Salmon and is gonna keep us at Gleno. Once we approach Gleno, we're gonna have to manually go to heading mode and fly the hold manually. So now we are 1.7 miles. We have the OBS selected, direct Gleno on the 247 course inbound. 1.5 miles is telling us we arrived at waypoint. 0.3, I'm gonna synchronize my heading bug. I will select heading mode, and now I will start the right turn. In Denver Center, Cessna 106 Tango established on the hold at Gleno, 17,000 feet. I will have my timer ready. That way, when we are abeam Gleno, I will start the timer for 1:30. So there it is, started the timer. Notice that even once we pass Gleno, the flight plan stopped the sequence and it stayed on Gleno because we pressed the OBS. Now we're just gonna wait until we hit 1:30 before we start our right turn. There's 1:30 starting the right turn. And of course, I will continue to do this hold. That is how you enter the hold using the two methods. One, using the OBS. The other one, mainly found in the newer systems of the G1000, is the built-in hold option. To learn this option, you actually have to put it in real practice. practice. The simulator is a great platform to understand these procedures because you actually do need to have hands-on experience to understand how they work. To learn more about SimTech, please visit our website, aviator.nyc.